One of the master keys to whole body power is the human ridgepole. Dr. Yancey Orchard will explain this concept to you so you may practice it. But first, what is the ridgepole in Chinese internal martial arts? The ridgepole is the human spine. Cervical, thoracic, lumbar, and coccyx all working together. The spine gives support and structure to the body. We call that the ridgepole. In every martial art form that you've ever seen, if it's done correctly, there is a proper ridgepole, the spine supporting all of the other limbs and movement. If this movement is not correct and the ridgepole is leaning or out of alignment, improper alignment will not fully transmit kinetic energy into the target. When you have proper alignment, your skeleton helps transmit this energy from the ground to the fist or any part of the body, as you see here. This is known as whole body force. The ridgepole principle means no leaning front, back, left, or right. It is the key to whole body force. We even use this when we're sitting in meditation or quiet sitting. It is an important part of all training in Chinese internal martial arts, especially in jamzhong, or what is known as standing, and in all forms, this must be obeyed. And now, here is Dr. Orchard.
So you may have noticed, as we were going through, a recurring image that you got was of the head lifting and the pelvis sinking. This creates a very upright vector in your body. We call this the ridgepole. There's a bunch of different ways we can go about generating this. The one that works most often for most people is to just stand for a moment. You want to make sure you're not shifting sideways like this and doing this and getting all of this. You're just getting very, very good posture, but we have a particular idea of what that posture is. So that sacrum needs to drop down again, okay? So standing with your butt up like this doesn't help. Overcorrecting it like this doesn't help. We want it to drop down. You want to take a look at your upper back and make sure it's not collapsing in. So let the upper back open up forward without pushing your ribs out or really expanding your chest. Keep your head lifting and your pelvis sinking. That's one way of doing this. Another way of doing this is finding your center with your mind. Okay, a couple of fingers below your belly button in the middle of your body. Try and get your mind to feel that spot. From that spot, press down in your mind. Don't tighten any muscles, but just feel like there's a force going down that you're creating, pushing your feet against the floor, pushing the floor farther away. So you can feel the bottom of your feet, and you can feel the center, and then you've got a direction going downwards. Relax that feeling. Go back to the center. Then from the center, come up to the top of the head and feel like you're driving that head up. You're not lifting your center. From that stable center, you're pressing up to the top of the head like a tent pole. Hold that feeling. Let that feeling come away. Come back down to that center and press down again. So you can feel the legs pressing into the ground without tensing. This is an intentional thing. It's not tightening all your muscles to do anything. You're just imagining that you're pressing down and noticing how your body turns on the fascial system. Then relax that, come back to the center, and press up. If you have a lot of trouble with this, tapping the top of the head, poking the bottom of your feet will help you feel those spots. Come back down to the center. This time, try and go in both directions at once. Press the ground down and your head up from that center. Some of you guys are very clever, and you'll decide, well, you just go from the feet up to the top of the head. Well, that will make you float. You go from your head all the way down to your feet. You'll miss the idea. It's really essential that we start from the center and go in both directions at the same time. Turn that feeling on. Back to the center. Turn that feeling on again. Up and down at the same time. Notice whether you tightened your body up. Let go of that tension. You can do this completely relaxed. This is not about how you're squeezing your muscles. Back down to the center and turn that feeling on again. This is a feeling that you should be able to hold all the time. When you go for lunch, when you're sitting in a chair, when you're walking around during your day. If you don't train it that way, it will only take you 15 or 20 years to get. If you train it that way every day, maybe in a month.